He instead called for money to be spent on building a strong European defense union. Answering questions after his speech, he said, "I consider the figure difficult." He said if Germany spent 2% of its GDP on NATO defense every year for 10 years, it would spend more than 70 million euros every year. He added, "I'm not quite sure after 10 years all European partners would consider that a good idea." Germany has agreed to increase its defense spending, and part of that will go into the European Defense Fund, and he believes the EU defense capabilities will complement but not replace NATO, saying it has nothing to do with President Trump. He said it was unfair for America to shoulder the burden of NATO and European defense. He added in his speech, "As the only vegetarian, we will have a damn hard time in the world of carnivores." He also said the EU also needs a military power option if it wants to survive in the world. He used the speech as an opportunity to call on the US to work more closely with the European Union, saying a stable and prosperous Europe is also in US national interests, adding, "A cooperation with Europe and US is important to maintain architecture of freedom." Gerhard Schröder spoke about EU security in Munich today, hopes the US can work together with the EU and help terminate the North Korea nuclear program, and in the face of a growing threat from Russia and China. He continued, "We are seeking a close coordination with our American allies. Our success will also depend on the way we deal with each other. Powers like China or Russia try to test and to undermine the EU's unity." SPD leader Martin Schulz and Thomas Oppenmann, who heads the centre-left party in parliament, have both hit out at the NATO target in the past and against Angela Merkel, who, "It's not only unrealistic, it is simply the wrong goal," they said in comments late last year. Saturday, February 17, 2018, Prime Minister Theresa May rules out second referendum at the Conference of Sigma, wants money put towards an EU defence budget. They also accused German Chancellor Angela Merkel and her conservatives of kowtowing to the demands of President Trump late last month. A senior US military official said if Germany didn't give 2%, it will weaken the NATO alliance. Army Secretary Mark Esper told reporters during a visit to troops in Wiesbaden, Germany, "It's important for all of our NATO allies to live up to the commitments. If not, it weakens the alliance, clearly, and Germany is such a critical member of NATO." Sigmar's comments come after Jens Stoltenberg, NATO's Secretary General, issued a warning shot during a stark address in Brussels this week. The Norwegian warned Brussels against overstepping its mark as the European bloc pursues plans for a joint EU army. The NATO chief told reporters that the EU will lose out if they try to undermine NATO by duplicating its role in the world. Speaking after a meeting of NATO defense ministers, Mr. Stoltenberg said that will be the same as competing with themselves. They will really be the losers if they end up with two competing structures, with two competing capability targets and lists. The minister spoke ahead of Prime Minister Theresa May, who is to propose a unique new UK-EU treaty on security, and urge Europe's leaders to show real political will to protect and enhance existing cooperation after Brexit. She will call on the European Union to maintain the safety of the bloc after Brexit. The 54th Security Conference in Munich is entering the second day. Europe, Turkey and nuclear deterrence are among the items on the agenda.